Yo, what is up, everybody? Zan's Epic Kid here, back again with a very new Hetalia fan game that just came out called Screamtalia. What's your favorite movie? I don't know what my favorite horror movie, I assume they're asking, is. Perfect Blue was pretty scary. Well, I feel like that's more of a thriller. One of them is Suspiria, the 1970-something version. I just like the style of it and the sort of unique themes. Anyways, this game was made by Lunar Projections, released on Game Jolt. That's an interesting, unusual choice of where to post Hetalia fan games, but that's been done. And if his name sounds familiar, that is because he also worked on Het Alternate during the Hetaphobia game jam, which was his second jam, I believe. He was in a team with Kyokun64, Gay Sun, and Darling Satanist, and he was responsible for the mapping and the coding of the game, which I thought was pretty good, actually. And here, this game is featuring Russia, Spain, and France, the Bad French Trio, a very well-loved trio, thanks to the War of the Austrian Succession episode and everyone being like, oh my god, these three would wreck some shit together. But yeah, I prefer Bad French Trio, not Bad Touch Trio, because that second name has negative connotations regarding, like, mischaracterizations of them. For a trio that is so popular, it's kind of surprising that there is hardly any Hetalia fan games revolving around them. Let me know if there's any more so I can try and play it. This is made on MZ. I'm thinking that they're gonna watch some scary movies and then some actually scary stuff is about to happen. So I'm kind of excited to play it. And yeah, let's begin. So the thing I like about... Ooh! Oh my gosh. Just have to say, I do enjoy Lunar Projections' coding and mapping skills. Oh gosh, we already have this freaking creepy synth. I'm loving this. Nice base set art. You can see the clear horror theme with the window skin here. An upside of MZ is that you are able to use your mouse alongside your buttons when controlling, and you can choose what sort of tile set sizes you want. So if it doesn't matter if you have MZ MV styled or XP VXA styled graphics, you can include whichever one. You just gotta change the settings, and I think that's impressive. Hola?
Hello.
What is this? Freaking ghost face calling? See?
Who is this?
Who are you trying to reach? Well, you have a very gravely sounding voice.
What number is this?
What number are you trying to reach? Spain. Oh gosh.
I don't know. I'm having an existential crisis.
I think you have the wrong number.
Do I?
Probably. It happens. Take it easy. Spain. He's so easygoing. Oh. Are we actually starting the game? Oh, okay. Hola? Soy Dora? No, I'm kidding.
I'm sorry. I guess I dialed the wrong number.
So, why did you dial it again?
Because my mother told me it is always good to apologize when you made a mistake. To apologize, see?
You're forgiven. Bye now, I'm still cooking.
Wait, don't hang up. I'm lonely.
What? Why?
I want to talk to you for a second.
They've got 900 numbers for that. Adios! So. Ah, Romano. I hope he's doing well. Whoever he is. And then we got Prussia and France panning up here.
Russia, why is the selection so old this time around? All of these go from the 60s up to 1991.
They've got some good classic horrors, though. And one perk is that there's practical effects involved, so you won't have to deal with bad CGI. Oh yeah, there were episodes in Hetagame World Twinkle, was it? In which the main characters and I guess a few others, including Canada and Spain and India, they all came together, met up, showed each other styles of horror movies. Actually, one of the covers that Italy showed for his own spaghetti horror movies was the cover for the original Suspiria, which I've cited before was one of my favorite horrors. Well, it was my turn to pick a movie when I wanted to pick an older one. A lot of older movies helped set the path for the future movies to improve on, grow, and get better. Oh yeah, as far as horror goes, I also like 28 Weeks Later. I also seen some scenes from 28 Days Later to help me with bioterror. It looked really nice for the time, but the story was good. Besides, these are some awesome films! Really? Dab. Just waiting. I miss all the ones you picked as slashers. Yes, the slashers. Like Scream, we got Friday the 13th, we've got Halloween. I actually did watch the newest Halloween movie. It was okay. Had interesting ideas, but Halloween, Sleepaway Camp, Prom Night, Daryl Train. Oh yeah, there's also Carrie. Where's the supernatural element? Your newest movie you have in the stack is Silence of the Lambs. Oh yeah, I also watched that one too. Really good. Have some with that. Like Hellraiser? Yes, Hellraiser. They actually did a Dead by Daylight DLC on that. You can actually see several slasher villains as characters in the game Dead by Daylight, and you can play as either one of them or as a survivor trying to run away from them and escape. The Howling, The Evil Dead, Carrie, Fridays the 13th Part 2, A Nightmare on Elm Street, The Exorcist! Okay, yeah, I did watch The Exorcist. My dad, who usually is fine with my siblings and I watching them super violent horror movies as kids, didn't want us to watch until we were older, and I can see why. There was some pretty disturbing material in it, at least for me. And well, with Hellraiser, you got the monster Pinhead. I think he's from a different dimension. And if you do, I haven't watched the actual movie, if you somehow solve a puzzle box, then he arrives, and yeah, bad stuff happens.
That may be true, but what about these other ones? What do you mean? Psycho, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, The Towns That Dreaded Sundown? These are more so based on true stories.
Psycho, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, haven't seen the original, I saw one of the movies.
Loosely based on them. The Exorcist is also based on a true story, but you know,
supposedly Annabelle is as well.
Besides, the movies I have picked out have a specific formula and a set of rules.
And among newer horrors, I think I enjoyed Megan? Malignant? Was that what it was called? Yeah, Malignant was more so like fun. I don't know, there was a point where I just started cracking up. The first movie, at least, was good too. But more as entertaining than scary.
Rules for a horror movie? What are they? Oh no, here we go. You see, a set of horror movies from this era have to follow a strict set of rules in order to survive. So yeah, France, you're dead because you're not a virgin. But I will live! Oh great. Good for you, Brasha. For the OG movies, there's four rules to always follow. Number one, no sex! Sex is a big no-no. Now, rule 2 and 3, no drinking, no drugs.
True.
Now for the last rule, you never want to say, I'll be right back, hello, or who's there? It's an automatic death sentence. But why is those phrases a death sentence? I mean, asking who's there or hello are common things to say. Because it means the killer in the movie is after you. Duh! Please tell me that all of the movies you brought don't follow these rules. Because I am definitely dead. Of course not! I mean, take a look at Carrie, for instance. There's non-virgin characters that survive, and even virgin characters who do die.
I think Cabin in the Woods is a horror that actually played on those tropes. Like, they legit had a ritual based on a certain order in which they killed the characters. You've got the fool, you've got the hoe, you've got the athlete, and then you've got the virgin. And the virgin can either live or die. But if we are going by old horror movie tropes, I would say that Spain could be the final guy / girl. Because France, obviously, the sex and drugs thing. Prussia, he drinks beer, is kind of an asshole. Some asshole characters tend to get killed off, but I love this dude, so.
Also, sequels have a whole different set of rules to follow. What are they? The kill count is bigger. There's more elaborate death scenes with more blood and gore.
Yay. Spain, he's loving this. Oh yes, I love all the blood.
And the last rule for the sequels is to never, ever, under any circumstances, assume the killer is dead. You want to double tap the killer to make sure they're dead, not just faking it.
So what about a trilogy?
No. Oh no, he's encouraging the aunt. Trilogies follow a whole new set of rules. You see, the killer's usually always going to be superhuman.
Yes, we have this with Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees.
Superhuman?
Actually, very first Friday the 13th, the killer wasn't actually Jason Voorhees, but, spoiler alert, his mom, who wanted revenge on the supposed teen counselors that were negligent in watching her son, allowing him to drown. And then I guess Jason came on in the movies afterwards.
Yeah, superhuman! Stabbing him won't do work. Shooting him won't work. Basically, in the third one, you got to cryogenically freeze his head, decapitate him, or blow him up. But you got to be careful. Anyone can die, including our final girl.
Well, that's a bit sad.
Yeah, but it's usually due to another rule. That being that the past will come back to bite you in the ass. Whatever you think you know about the past, forget it. The past is not at rest.
In that case, Spain's probably might be targeted.
Any sins you think were committed in the past are about to break out and destroy you. That's why it's also best never to be alone in this installment in the series.
I see. I guess that means remakes got to follow the structure?
No. Remakes have a whole new set of rules.
France really doesn't like this. No idea, ask what those are.
Yeah, I'm telling you anyway. I just want to watch a movie.
I mean, look, I enjoy the good movie auteur rant, but this is a bit too much.
Remakes pretty much throw everything out of the window. Death scenes tend to be way more extreme. There's always an opening sequence. New versions are always 2.0, so the latest technology is always involved and integral to the plot. That means the killer may start filming the murders.
Is there any way to survive in the modern horror film?
Yeah, but, well, you pretty much have to be gay to survive the modern day horror.
Yeah, I think modern day, they're just more worried about not following all of the usual tropes.
That's a bit insulting. I agree, but that's how it is. Which also brings me to another rule that I cannot stress enough.
And that is...
simple. You don't fuck with the original.
Cool.
There's some rules, other rules too, but I don't like them.
Like what?
Oh boy, what are they?
Nah. Oh.
I'd rather not say. They're rather racist and sexist.
Oh, you kind of typo.
Sexist rules from earlier films.
Oh yeah. Think I kind of know why.
That's the one thing I like about modern horror movies. They threw those rules away. Thank God.
Oh, I think I know which ones you're talking about. Yeah, I'm happy the slasher movies now don't follow those rules. That's why my selection has more gore and so on. Yeah. Though I still wonder where my copy of Repo, the genetic opera, went to.
Who knows? Anyways, we need to pick one for my stack.
Well, you brought a lot. Think we can down it to a few?
Alright. One process of elimination later. So it's down to Z6. See? Seems so? Which one are you going to pick, Brasha?
I feel like maybe, depending on which horror we choose, that might impact what sort of rules we might have to follow or what sort of conflict we're going to have to face later on in this game. So, I know nothing about sleepaway camp. Let's cross that out for now. Actually, let me look that up. Okay, so it's a 5-film slasher franchise. Serial killer Angela Baker and murder she commits largely at summer camp. First one was released in 1983, and it has a twist ending. And it has themes regarding gender identity. Well, criticism from modern reviewers regarding its themes. After reading through the summary, I can see why Sleepaway Camp got criticism for that. Anyways, let's see. At least know who's the serial killer here, but Carrie, I'm familiar with the story. Hellraiser is kind of new to me. Halloween, still sort of new. Oh, I only watched maybe like one scene from it. Friday the 13th, like I know I knew the twist at the end, but I didn't really watch that either. So I think the one that I'm most familiar with, at least story-wise, would be Carrie. So let's pick this. How about Sisfon? Hello? Hello?
A lovely night, isn't it?
Who is this?
Why don't you tell me?
I don't have time for your stupid games. Bye!
Hold on. Don't hang up.
I said bye!
You hang up on me and I'll make sure all three of you suffer.
What?
You heard me. You, the blonde one, and the brunette. You will suffer.
At this point, I would just think, bruh, shut up. This prank call is not funny. Hang up.
Brasha, what's wrong? Are the doors locked? Easy, oh, hi.
Well, are the windows locked?
Nice try, buddy, but... Or is the chimney locked?
Oh, I see you put on Carrie. That's a good choice. Too bad you won't have time to see it.
How did that happen? Spain? I have no idea. Maybe they snuck in? Why is it break your box? Nagura, do I? Could you go check it out? See if anyone broke in?
Well, that's a bad idea.
What? I mean, I can. Okay. We'll be back.
I'll be back, he says. And then he is found hacked to bits in the shower after.
You know, if the breaker was full, why is the TV the only thing on? I don't know.
Oh my god, Samara's gonna crawl out of the TV! No! Okay, so we got this.
Ooh, settings, record and eject. Okay. Always dash, touch UI.
He's a country, his level is 25. So he has to go to the breakers. And that would be in the basement. Is it right here? No, it's all... Of course, it's in the...
Oh man, I forgot to clean up again. I don't have time to clean up. Just need to push through and get to the breaker box.
Push the boxes to make your way. If you get stuck, exit the room and re-enter. Okay, I know this is kind of a puzzle. Let's go. Push here. I like this. Okay. That's...
Finally made it! Huh? All the switches are normal. What's going on? Wait. Was that window always open? Huh, weird.
Oh god.
What the hell, man? Why is it only the stupid TVs that's on? Maybe something supernatural? Like a poltergeist or something? Please don't joke around about that!
Hello? Will you do be able to explain this? Don't think I've ever heard of it.
A girl who could do this? So it must be a ghost! Night! can't be that. This isn't a horror movie. Once the power comes back on, oh, damn it, I skipped, sorry. Well, the circuit didn't get flipped. It's really strange. What? See? Ghosts. I love the switch up here. France seems more confident while Prussia is more scared. Gah! Well, I don't think it was a spirit or anything. Maybe it's just the weird, strange power outage that cut off all the electricity but the TV. I still think it's a spirit messing with us. I mean, we have known a lot of people who have passed. Maybe one finally got enough strength to lash out at us. Oh, I hope it's not easy. Yeah, no, no, no! Don't joke about that crap! Well, regardless, we should find a flashlight or something. I think there's one in the office. Right, France, you go get it. Why me? Cause! Are you scared you might find the ghost? No! Alright.
Dab. Awkward silence. Ah, me.
Come on, you two, let's go as a group.
Okay, now we can record here. Oh, I see. Their levels are their physical ages. Well, Precious is more speculated. I forgot what we were supposed to do.
I don't think it'd be a good idea to go outside right now.
Let's play the piano. No. We can pretend to be it and escape. Okay, let's go up. What's behind door number one? An attic that we cannot access right now. What's behind door number two? Another bedroom with a computer. What's behind door number three? A bathroom! True horrific setting. Like something could just pop right out of it.
What the hell? I knew it. That's not supposed to be happening.
A flashlight, a bullet, and a lock?
How is it happening? Calm down, it's just the phone. All right. Are you going to answer it?
Yeah. It could be hungry, to be honest, if it does turn out to be an actual nation. Hello?
I hope you don't think this is all we have. We're just getting started.
Hey, who is this? Hello? Hello? Got verdammt!
Did they FaceTime him?
Hey, come on. Let's just grab the flashlight and go.
I'm not touching that!
It's only floating.
Yeah, but what if whoever is doing this to us gets pissed at us? Suppose something freaks out and calls us to run upstairs when we should be running out the front door!
Don't be silly, Prussia. Besides, we're already upstairs.
Ah! Okay, never mind.
Gasp! It's Ghostface!
Went up that far.
Holy fuck, why tonight of all nights? The villa is on Halloween, my friend. But right now, we need to focus on surviving the night, got it? Got it, but where should we hide for the night?
Well, I have an attic we could hide in, or rather a small storage room.
Sweet, let's get to it.
It's in the room that he just went in.
Where is it?
Well, it's in the room the masked figure went into.
What? Why did you suggest if that was the case?
I didn't think of that. Well, we could try the upstairs bathroom. If it locks and there's a window if we need to climb out of it.
That sounds like a better idea than an attic. Come on, let's get to it.
Can I pick this thing up? Nah.
Nope, that's it! Got to run! Ah! Motherfucker!
Oh damn, this bitch teleports. Poggers! Poggers! Why am I shouting poggers? The power of...
Are you gonna pop out of me?
Come at me, motherfucker! Oh, did I get stabbed? Ew! Come at me, ho! Game over. Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. And it closed! Great! Luckily, I can save scum. So, the moment we go into a room, we'll be royally fucked over. So, in that case, what is the correct thing to do? We run out the front door, duh. No! Are you kidding me? Okay. So, let's see. Let's see if we can outsmart this motherfucker.
God! Oh god, please, please!
Oh no, it's an army!
Please!
Rawr.
AC Emmy?
Eh?
Huh, your faces are priceless right now.
But what? What?
Finland?
Romano?
England?
Gee, thanks. We're totally here too.
What's going on? Why are you doing this?
Why? I'm sure you remember a few months ago. In the summer.
When I was babysitting!
Oh,
I remember that game.
Ah, yeah, I do. This is revenge.
Oh, I remember him telling us about that. Loves a prank.
Honestly, wouldn't have happened if you two didn't ditch him.
Huh?
He's right, you know. If you two idiots didn't ditch him, he wouldn't have pranked Finland in the first place.
Romano, come on. Okay, I get it. You got me back. But how did you do the thing with the lights? And the floating items? And the TV?
Oh, that was easy. England and Iceland took care of the floating items in the blackout. Ladonia lent us a hand in hacking into your smart TV to keep it on to scare you.
Well, you did a good job. It was more entertaining than any of the movies Brush and brought for movie night.
Movie night? Oh, that sounds like fun. Come on, let's go watch a movie.
Alright.
Yay!
Yeah, Finland's hardcore like that. The end. Loosely based on Scream. Game is a short sequel to my game When the Stranger Calls Finland. I remember that game now. I loved it. Springs. By Lunar Projections, Faces by Tema! Ooh, screenshots by Tema. I love the art style. Title art by Tema. Title card by Lunar Projections. And custom assets by Lunar Projections. Map done. Coding. And RPG Maker MZ. And yep, ending credits. I like the videos. And yeah, it was a good homage to the slasher movies. I feel like there was too much gameplay elements, but I feel like this would be a fun short game for Halloween. So, good job! Thank you. So, the previous game that they were mentioning was When a Stranger Calls Finland, which was a game where Finland was babysitting Kugelmugel and Ladonia. And Finland got this scare from Prussia that he was a creepy stranger coming to attack. And then Finland brought out a shotgun and shot at him. But Prussia survived, thankfully. But still, not cool, man. Then I suppose after all, the movie that you choose doesn't really matter. Disappointing, but you know. Man, Finland is scary when he wants to be. He seems focused on the movie. It won't bother him. Wants me to play something else. I think Labyrinth of Lost Dreams is good for now. Oh, Kronos! Well, I usually help Lunar with his games. I didn't get to work on this one. Aw. It's a nice avatar you've got here. Ooh. Recognize. That's Lunar? Hey! Thank you kindly for playing. Thank you. I know the game was really, really short, but it was just for fun. As mentioned in the credits, this game is a short sequel to my other game known as When a Stranger Calls Finland. I hope you like it and look forward to whatever I make next. Who knows what horror movie I'll take inspiration from next. Okay. Check out the art, yeah. Yay, thank you. This is Tema, or well, a representation through an OC, but a rep nonetheless. Aw. I like their design. I have no idea what's happening, but I got dragged into this project like 6 months ago. Pretty sure this is their excuse to ramble about horror tropes. I'm just here to draw the pretty pictures. I'm a sham, I'm not even... What? I mean, yeah, that's true, but I like their drawings. They're really nice. The imposter syndrome is immense here, but I have no idea what they're talking about, but I'm glad they're happy. The pressure being hit by a squeaky hammer is my peak of face set design, and everything from here on out is downhill. Yes, that was memorable. I'm just here to make the bets. Lunar's the king of professionalism. Hope you enjoyed the game, though. Thank you. I did. See, talk to Finland. Oh my god, he turned in sitting position. I feel so much better after that. I was on a date with a pretty lady when Finland contacted me to help him with his plan. Oh. Why did I help? Well, why not? I mean, you wouldn't know what to do since you're into the supernatural. While the day is Halloween, I must say I'm happy that it was just them and not someone from our past. Girl, you got several people in the past who you might not want to meet in such a way again. So that was Screamtalia. What's your favorite scary movie? And I gotta say, that was pretty fun. It was short, but sweet, and well, we got some good entertainment from there. So, what's your favorite scary movie, guys? I mean, if we're talking about favorite horror games, which I haven't actually played, just watched, I enjoy Silent Hill, I enjoy Clock Tower, and yeah, the newest one, there is a very new game called Paranormasite that I like. Those are all kind of Japanese-made ones, though. But yeah, I hope this was entertaining, and thank you for those who made the game, and thanks everyone for watching. See ya!